Hi everyone! Today I'll be looking at how to shoestring a Super Looper in Open Roller Coaster Tycoon 2. This ride is best known for its installations made by Larson International called Fireball, but you may also know it as the Super Loop or Ring of Fire. These kinds of rides can be found at both smaller fairs and larger theme parks, and it's a great ride to add if your park needs a thrilling ride but doesn't have a lot of space left. This is a slightly more advanced shoestring design, so it will help if you already have at least a basic knowledge of shoestringing in OpenRCT 2. It can be a very fiddly ride to build, so if you haven't made a shoestring ride before, I don't recommend starting here, but I've linked a great starter tutorial for a flat merry-go-round type ride by Zarathustra in the description. I also want to give a big shout out to the Replacements team and their park Storybrooke Glen, which is where I learned how to build this ride. It's a great park and I put a link to it in the description as well. So if you're ready, let's get started. Alright, let's start by selecting the cheats we're going to need enabled for this hack to work. So we're going to start with Clearance Checks Disabled, Support Limits Disabled in this menu, and in our Ride Cheats menu we're going to also need Building in Pause Mode, Enable All Drawable Track Pieces, Show All Operating Modes, Unlock Operating Limits, Allow Arbitrary Ride Type Changes, Show Vehicles from the Track Types, and Disable Vehicle Limits. So like most flat ride shoestrings, we're going to be doing a three ride method. We're going to be starting with the display track, and I'm going to use the vertical drop coaster to build that. So we're just going to build our loop here, and I'm going to start this up at 85 feet. Our base surface height is 50 feet. That will become important later on. So we're just going to build two slopes up, do two quarter loops, and the slopes back down. And that's all it is for the display track. We're going to go ahead and color this yellow for clarity. Next, we'll build our ride track, and I'll be using a vertical drop coaster for this as well. We'll start with our station piece, and we're going to build it up right next to the display track here. And we'll make sure that it's at the same base height here. We're using 85 feet for both. And I'm going to start with five pieces of track behind the station. This is where our trains will spawn. Next, we'll do a bit that comes out. This is for the control train. And this will do a turnaround and then go underground. And we're going to end it here, directly underneath where we started, more or less. Right, and the final bit we need for this track is the part of the track that the real train will travel on that will take us to the loop. So we're going to do an S-bend out of this rear part of the spawn track, the ride track, and build towards the loop. And as you see, we're going to be building this slope up here, right on top of the slope that exists on the display track, and now we've merged together. Finally, we'll go ahead and re-add this straight piece behind the station we deleted. And that will be it for the ride track. So the exact layout of this ride track is kind of up to you. There are just a couple important things we need to remember. One is that the direction of the display track, the yellow loop, needs to be in the same direction as the ride track that gets merged into it. And we also need to have the end of the ride track that will go underground into the control track be more or less on the same X and Y coordinate as it started. And the reason we do that is because when guests get off the ride, they're going to walk from where the first car is towards the exit. And if it's, you know, off somewhere else, we don't want them to walk all the way across the map. It's going to look unnatural. All right, so let's go ahead and add some trains here. We're going to be using the corkscrew roller coaster trains. You can use whatever trains you want in theory. I think the corkscrew roller coaster trains look the best. And we're going to be doing one train of seven cars per train. And just for clarity, we'll be coloring the front two cars white, and we'll leave the rest of them red. The front two cars will wind up being our control cars, and the rest will be the real train that the guests will ride in. So we'll rename this ride track, and for clarity, I'm going to color this one bright red. And we're going to change the mode type to power launch without passing station, and 31 miles per hour is a pretty good place to start with. We can play around with this later, but I think 31 is probably going to be where we're going to end up anyway, so that should work out just fine. The knowledge that we don't have our control track built yet, let's just give this a quick test, and I'm going to pause right before it blows up, but we'll see how things line up after we build our entrance and exit, of course. Okay, so if you've done everything correctly, you should see something like this. We've got our white cars, which are our control cars, underneath, and our red cars, which are the real ride cars, up on top, about to head into the loop. And the red cars aren't quite in the middle of the loop yet, so we're gonna need to add a couple more pieces on our ride track, but that's not a big deal. This is just something we can adjust as we go. And we'll give this a test just to see how it lines up, and we can continue to adjust this as we go. Okay, I think this is gonna look pretty good. Okay, so let's build our control track. We're gonna use another vertical drop coaster. Actually, I'm gonna start by deleting a couple of these pieces from the ride track just for easy merging later on. So we'll have our control track down here at the bottom level where our ride track is going to meet up with it. We're going to start with a single station piece, a gentle slope up, and then we'll flatten it out. What we're going to be building here is essentially a two-layered piece of track. And as our train launches out of the station, it's going to start at the station below and then launch out onto a track above it, where it will do most of its traveling. So let's merge these two together by building a couple of straight pieces into each other. We'll end with the ride track, so that should merge correctly. And let's do another test on this to see where everything lines up. Okay. It looks like we need to add one more tile of space to get the red train lined up, so let's do that real quick. All right, this looks pretty good. So you can see that the middle car on our ride train is pretty close to the middle bottom of the loop here, as our white train is parked in the bottom control station. So let's continue to work on our control track, and I'm going to rename it, and we'll color it green, just a little bit brighter green so it's easier to see. And let's get rid of these trains. So the way we're going to do this is we're going to delete that slope up, and we're going to continue to building this top layer backwards, and this will make sense as we go. We're gonna have a couple straight pieces backwards, and then we're gonna add some boosters. These boosters are gonna all be set to about 58 miles per hour, something in that range, and then a few more straight pieces behind it. And then in front, we'll have some more boosters. And what this will accomplish is that once the control train is on this top layer of the control track, it's going to go back and forth between these two sets of boosters as gravity pulls the ride train around the loop. So we'll go ahead and merge the station back into the top layer here. And we will use our tile inspector and make sure that the straight piece at this merge point is below the other piece in the list. That way when the train boosts out of the station, it will remain on the top layer. So let's give that a test and see how it goes. All right, so it successfully boosted out of the station. We hit the front booster section a little bit too early, so we can tweak that. So let's go ahead and delete a couple of these, and instead we'll add them a couple tiles in front instead. and give that another test. All right, so here you can see the control train is going to move back and forth between these two booster sets, and it will gradually gain more and more speed until it has enough speed to clear the second set of boosters. So you can see that in this particular setup, it cleared the boosters pretty easily. And this is something that we can continue to tweak as we prefer. This particular ride is pretty easy to kind of get any different kind of behavior you want as far as how long you want it to remain on the bottom of the loop before it makes it all the way around. So you can continue to tweak the placement of these boosters and test it as much as you like. So let's finish building our control track. We're gonna add more straight sections of track and maybe some more boosters. Okay, we'll crank these up to about 58. And then finally, we're going to have a hill up into a vertical spike. And when the control train reaches the end of this vertical spike, it's going to pull the rest of the train back down, and it's going to go around the track in the opposite direction. Now to return it to the station, we're going to add some more lower level track. So we're going to delete a piece between these two booster sections. We'll do a hill up, which will be a hill down as the train's traveling backwards at this point. And some straight track back to the station. And before we get there, we'll add some brakes to slow it down a little bit. Make sure it actually hits that station. And it can stop just fine. And finally, we'll reconnect. And let's use our tile inspector to make sure that these pieces are ordered correctly. We're going to want the lower portion to be lower down in the tile inspector list, so that when the train is traveling backwards through this section, it's going to go backwards downward onto the lower level of the track. All right, let's give this another test. All right, working perfectly. And again, you can tweak the placement of the boosters here on the control track to adjust the behavior. Kind of mix and match the placements of the boosters as you want to get whatever ride length you like. It's up to you. All right, finally it's time to make some tweaks and final touches on our ride. One thing you can do is change the vertical drop coaster type on the display track to something else. As you saw earlier in the video, Storybrooke Glen uses a LIM launch roller coaster. Those two are really the only great options. You could also use single rail coaster if you want something a little bit thinner, or hybrid coaster if you're feeling spicy, but I prefer to go with the vertical drop coaster personally because I think it looks the nicest. So just like most shoestring rides, we're going to have to hide our control track and our ride track. Before we do that, we should probably fix our entrance and exit so that guests can actually get on our ride. So I'm going to go ahead and copy and paste my entrance, and let's put it a little bit closer to the loop. Probably about there is good. And then we can delete the old one and make the new one usable. And I'll go ahead and do the same thing with the exit. Of course, you can put these anywhere you like, rotate them any direction, totally up to you and how your park layout is handled. So now that that's done, let's go ahead and add our queue just so we know where that will go. And we're going to turn our ride track and our control tracks both into unknown ride to make those disappear. We're almost done. One final thing, we got to hide these control cars. Even if you put your control track underground, like you do for most shoestring rides, you do still have that giant vertical spike that these are going to travel up, and you're going to be able to see those cars, and it's going to look pretty ugly. So let's go ahead and hide those. And I'm going to use the Edit Ride Vehicles plugin, This is a fantastic plugin. If you don't already have it, there'll be a link to that in the description. And we'll go ahead and get our ride track selected. I'm going to turn these into 3D cinema, but any ride will do. Most flat rides will do for this. And make sure you change the number of seats on them to 0. So you don't have guests riding in those invisible cars. And there you have it. I hope this video was helpful. If there's something you'd like to see in the future, let me know in the comments. And there you go. There's our functioning. Oh, you've got to be kidding me. Why would it do that?